So, what did you die to the most in your PB Nax? Hey, thanks, Bathhouse. Penetrator. Oh yeah, you said you lost 40 minutes to Penetrator. Is that a raid? Monty versus the world. Thank you for the raid. That Canadian guy? Who, me? I'm not Canadian. Oh, Nax, yeah. Nax is Canadian. Oh my god, nice quit out. I haven't had any good asylums. Thanks, Lurie. Oh my god. Nubis, thank you for the host. I'm just getting so many hosts and raids. Yeah, I like it too, Bathhouse. Hey Nubis, thanks man. How was any percent for you? I rolled. Okay, it's not a good start. Practice. It feels good to not constantly lose runs to him, like I was yesterday. Thanks, Coco. I made sure to practice him today. It didn't take me very long to, like, get back to being decent at him. I haven't lost a run to him yet. Dude, toggling out of the riposte so fast. Feels so good. It does seem chill because you don't have to do that early flame lurker fight, for sure. Yeah, well, next, you've also been speedrunning other games, too. I definitely sympathize with Birdo. Like, just starting speedrunning, it's like, give me the easy shit that's not that much slower. Although, I did start with BKH, so I don't know. I didn't quite do that. With all bosses, I did that. I did DT plus 5 to start with all bosses, so. Please fall. Please do a ring attack. Alright, cool. You know, I have yet to get the wind cycle on Iron Golem in all of my runs. He hasn't done the stomp a single time. Which I haven't been running this for super long, but still, you'd think he'd do it once. He does it in practice all the fucking time for me. Like, I'll be trying to practice the Sastasim Golem, and he just fucking goes straight into the stomp. It's like super annoying. And in runs, he never fucking does it. Get that Canadian goal. Oh yeah, I would like to see Nax do that, because Birdo peaches the shit out of that. Birdo just like punches and backstabs them to death and then runs past. Like, I think the first two rolling skeletons, or do you do the first three? Yeah, the first three. Yeah. It's pretty slow, but it's... I guess it's better than dying. Just run, then usually die, yeah. I'd say, Birdo, whenever you get a deathless run, that'd probably be the first thing that I would learn if I were you, how to get through that area safely and quickly. I mean, you have a lot of time to save in other places, so it's not a big deal right now. Whenever you get, like, your first deathless run, if it were me, that would be the first thing that I would work on. Well, learn to skip. Like, you can just... Like, that wouldn't be a hard thing to practice either. Like, you can just load up 4-1 over and over again. Just practice it. You think you'd move on from magic by then? Well, still, you're going to have to run past them either way. Or lose, like, a ton of time killing them. It does seem really fucking annoying, though, so I don't blame you. Like, those guys are super assholes. I remember trying to just run past them in SO1 and, like, just dying over and over again. Like, I would just try to run past and then quit out. But, of course, quitting out in Demon Souls takes, like, a million years because of the menu lag. So I'd still just die. started up my running attack way too early. Come on. Really? She got gnomed twice last week. That doesn't surprise me. Baby. That's Birdo's favorite combo. Nice running attack. That's how you're supposed to do it. Nice gargoyle, Halberd. That's probably my favorite combo. Hey, Borya. Yeah, it's a classic. Also, I don't think I've had a good Queelog fight yet. Either she gives me really bad RNG or I just screw up. That was okay. That was decent. Still got the stupid gargoyle halberd. Sorry. It's just how I have it. There's not a whole lot there, so. Like, that's probably like the least relevant piece of information. Glad you like the green screen. I mean, you can still see what's on the item bar, anyways. You're on part three now. Nice. Wow, actually managed to stick it out to the stupid camera. Just a firebomb. Dang it. I was supposed to save time there, too. I missed a bomb. Oh well. I wonder which one I missed. I'm not sure. There was one bomb that I threw where the camera, like, shifted on me. That might have been the one. Could have saved so much time there. Thank you, Danny. Fuck. Put myself where the character is. What about that? That was a scary plunge. Interesting idea, Berto. Alright, I can save a good bit of time for the rest of the run. A little bit on Guardian, and then a big chunk on Artorias and Gwen. Are you sure that that's, like, not just the emulator, though? Being weird? You don't think so? Okay. You didn't even void out? I teleported back up. Nice, okay. Cool boss. Because there's an item after Artorias that allows me to skip into the kiln. And it's very fast. So, like, after I kill Artorias, the run is almost over. Darkbeam. Nice jump. Dang it, I wish I hadn't got hit there. I took it really safe because I got hit there. Yeah, it wasn't great. I could have been more aggressive, but after I took that one hit, just kind of like wanted to make sure I didn't get killed. Hey, Enid. Oh, hey. I didn't recognize you with your name change. What's up, man?
You sorry.
Nice camera. God fucking damn it, dude. There we go. I kept accidentally clicking the stick down when I was trying to turn, and it was screwing up my camera and then screwing me up. Like, ugh. I mean, that was all my fault. Like, it was very annoying. Yeah, this glitch is nuts, dude. That's why that there's the, they split the categories up. There's like the no wrong warp category. But yeah, that's why you go to the DLC. Because that shit is fast. I think that's probably about the same amount of time that it took me to get the wrong warp on my PB, honestly. So I might not even save time here. Yeah, force quitting is banned in every category except for force quit. This isn't good. Yeah, since I fucked up there, I wasn't even gonna go for that. Still sub 34. Yeah, that was very interesting fight. That's sub Miko. So I went up one place. It's not a good ending. Yeah, I know, right? Come on. Yeah, that was a really spooky Gwen, but I wasn't gonna quit out. If he was gonna kill me, he was gonna kill me. I just wanted to go for it. I've salvaged fights like that before, but I didn't want to go for the parry, obviously, because then it would be just like I die if he gives me the wrong attack.